he's really created some tremendous value for us. He's a guy who does things right consistently, and really that's what produces successful games right there. These guys who really do things right consistently. Marcus, I think he's a really, really good athlete. Again, he got a little banged up early on, and we have to get him up to speed with our tempo and how we practice and how we do things. But I think what he's done is he's shown and flashed a fantastic athlete out there. Again, he's a guy that we wanted to stand him up playing that linebacker. Again, he can do that. He can put his hand on the ground, play some in and lean on fours outside on the edges. So I think he's going to bring another guy in the life of Bass. He's going to be consistent. He's going to do things right. And he's going to have the athletic ability that we need to rush the passer on the outside.
We've seen Nas Jones multiple positions a little bit on the line. What looks like your plan B is going to be without McDowell being here, that role to do multiple things?
Yeah, sure. I think he can fit that. Again, David Bass is a guy who can fit that role. Again, he can play multiple positions for us. Again, David Bass can rush inside for us on third down. Nas is a guy who can be able. Of course, in light of realizing that he's a young guy, but I think he's got the mind, he's got the brain to be able to handle multiple positions. Obviously, we want to be able to get him locked down and focused in on maybe one or two, and then as we get later on in the season, maybe get a third position out of him. But right now, again, it's interior for him. We want him to play some three technique, we want him to play some nose, and we want him to be a guy who's going to push the pocket on third down and get 6'5". So again, get those arms up, get in the quarterback's face, and let's get some tip balls.
That's a plus, the height, but how much of a challenge is it of a three technique guy without the leverage maybe of guards and centers who are shorter?
Well, he's got power. And as I said, it's pad level. That's all it's ever going to come down to, whether it's defending the run or getting after the quarterback in the pass rush. It's going to be pad level. Are we going to be low? Are we going to get off on the football? And do you have power? He's a guy who certainly has power.
What have you seen out of Pierre this year, what he's done in the preseason?
Yeah, I think he's shown himself well. He's shown true consistency within the technique. I think he's got a tremendous coverage ability. And really, he's got a great, fantastic attitude. He's done everything that we've asked of him. And as I said, he shows up in the big moments. Rarely ever out of position, which has been a really good sign. And if you are where you're supposed to be, 9 times out of 10, good things will happen.
Does his experience show up, having played in the league a little bit?
I think it does. And that's the poise. That's the, he's rarely ever panicked or anything of that nature. Somebody catches a ball, whatever, next play. But again, he's shown himself, I think, in the value, right, is he's stopping guys from throwing the ball over our heads. And yes, he has. He's done that.